So when you talk about biomes, you ultimately have to talk about the factors that help determine why one place is different from the other. And the two main factors is going to be temperature and precipitation. Of course, temperature has to do with the amount of sunlight that an area receives, and precipitation has to do, of course, with the amount of water that's available in that area. But when you're talking about that, you're talking about climate and weather. Remember, climate is the conditions of a certain place over a long period of time, while weather is what happens at a certain moment. So a sunny day or a rainy day, you're talking about weather. What you're talking about is usually heat, hot here, you're talking about climate. And you see the picture here that represents the climates around the world. And there are three major climate zones. You have the tropical zone, the temperate zone, and the polar zone. But within those zones, there's variations in climate because of the availability of water and other factors, which we're going to be discussing in this video. All right? Now, remember, of course, there's a climatologist and a meteorologist. Climatologist is basically a special type of meteorologist that studies the climate patterns. To study climate patterns, scientists use tools like they measure temperatures using thermometers, they measure humidity using a variety of tools, including hair hygrometers, dew cells. They also measure humidity. And you'll see examples of that over here in the instrument that it's used, a hygrometer. They also measure precipitation, or the amount of rainfall or snowfall, and they use meter sticks or rain gauges for that. They have measure wind speed, and they use basically wind gauges for that, or anemometers. And they also have wind direction, and you see here an example of how they measure that. And they also have air pressure, which is measured with barometers. You have that there. And you also have cloudiness, which is basically, how much cloud cover there is. So these are the factors that meteorologists will study: temperature, humidity, precipitation, wind speed, wind direction, air pressure, and cloudiness. And using these features, you can describe the weather of a certain place. And like I just mentioned before in this video, there are three major areas that have typical weather around the world. So the weather is pretty much similar throughout the year, or there's some patterns throughout the year. The area in the middle of the world that receives the most sunlight constitutes what we call the tropical zone. And you can see the amount of sunlight fluctuates throughout the year, but it actually, the middle of the year is usually hit by sunlight directly, and therefore it's going to have more heat. Then you have the temperate zones immediate above and below that, and the polar zones at the top and bottom of the world. But remember that there's variation within each of these zones on the actual climate because of the availability of water that exists in a certain place. And as you can see, the temperature and the precipitation, or the humidity, so sunlight and humidity are the two main factors that determine what a biome is going to be like. And so scientists represent that using a graph that's called a climatograph. A climatograph is basically a drawing like this, is a graph that shows you precipitation in bars and temperature with a line throughout the year in the same picture. So you see all the bars here means how much rainfall is falling throughout the year. And then the line represents temperature fluctuations. On the right side, over here, you have the indication for the temperature. And then on the left side, you have the indication for the precipitation. And so you follow along and notice how in Florida, it's hot throughout the year and it barely changes, with a little more hot during the summer months, but that the precipitation changes a lot more during the summer months than toward the winter months of the year. So it's a good example of a climatograph. By the way, it's because of so much heat and so much humidity that Florida is the way it is. So by looking at both the temperature and the humidity, you can have a good idea of the weather and climate of the place. So that's what this is for. Now, there's a lot of different things which determine the climate of our area. And in the next video, I'm going to go into detail about the factors that determine the climate. Now, although that's not directly knowledge that's going to be tested in biology, it is background knowledge from Earth-based science that you would be expected to know about in order to do well in the class. So I encourage you that you watch the video so you can understand some of the things we're going to be talking about next.